We typically notify you of the decision within 24 hours. Ha! Ha! So now I'm in this weird zone where there seems to be two appeals happening simultaneously. One of them has been denied and the other one is questionable. We don't know where we're at with it. All right. So I said, after weeks of waiting, a supervisor tells me that the channel will not be reinstated and the decision is fine. Wait, is that the one I just read? That's the one I just read. At this point, every other email I get is switching off from one employee to the next, and none of them seem to have any clue what the others are saying or doing. Here's where things get really interesting. I also received a message telling me a mistake was made and my account would be reinstated. Following? And an email saying the account is unsuspended, but the channel is still gone. So here is the message from one of their employees. You can see it's the same fucking emails I've been getting from all of them. Hi, Jesse. Thanks for waiting. Our team reviewed your channel termination appeal and found that your channel does not violate our spam, deceptive practices, and scams policies. Your channel was terminated by mistake. It will be reinstated. I apologize for this misunderstanding. YouTube, blah, blah, blah. Then, hi there. After a review of your... This is from like the official YouTube thing. After a review of your account, we have confirmed that your YouTube account is not in violation of our terms of service. As such, we have unsuspended your account. This means your account is once again active and operational. So obviously I sent this to the YouTube support people to try to figure out what's going on there, because that seems confusing, you know? And I say, I received an email from partner support saying that the appeal has been accepted already and the review process is over. And then Noriel says, awesome. Smiley face emoji. Uh-oh, Maria, watch out. Noriel's moving in on your territory. I said, but the account has not been restored. She says, please wait within 24 to 48 hours to restore your channel. I said, I'm being told two different things. Has the appeal been reviewed or not? Again, this is the girl who just told me that it's still under review. So it's under review. It's not under review. It's suspended. It's not suspended. She says, please share the email you received as our system shows that review of the appeal is still pending. I said, how do I share the email with you? She says, please share a screenshot. So I send her the screenshot. She says, thank you for sharing the screenshot. I'm checking it now. Thank you for waiting. I will consult our internal team regarding your channel status after winning the appeal. So now I got to wait again to hear back on three or four different decisions. I don't even know what I'm waiting for anymore at this point. A brand new guy steps in mid-email. So I'm in an email chain with another one, and a brand new guy shows up and asks me to once again submit an appeal because they can't figure out what was going on. Here it says, hi, hope all is well. This is Daryl stepping in for Noriel. I've got an update regarding your issue with your channel termination. I understand that you received an email confirming that your channel should have been reinstated. However, it still shows terminated on your end. In order to fix this, our internal team would like you to submit an appeal through this form. So how many appeals is that now? There's that first failed attempted one, the second one, the mysterious one where it's still under appeal already, even though the other lady says that it's not and the decision's been made. And now I've got to submit another appeal. So we're at four appeals on this. I said, lucky for me, during all of this, YouTube was kind enough to send me a survey to tell them if I am satisfied with how I am being slowly tortured. This is real. At the end of the comment chain with the woman who told me that my account will not be reinstated, I got a, how are you extremely satisfied survey. How extremely satisfied or dissatisfied are you? And of course, I'll read you what I actually responded to them with, if I can find it here. Let's see. Here's me saying very mean things to Reynaldo. here is, where is it? Where's my fucking, why can't I find this right now of all times? It's very strange. Oh, here it is. So I said, you want me to just complete a survey while my questions aren't being addressed and I'm being given the runaround? Needless to say, I'm extremely dissatisfied. Hope that doesn't blow your mind. So this is a nightmare, you know, that George Orwell could not envision. Okay. This is the kind of shit where, like, if they did this in a movie, you wouldn't buy it. Like, Idiocracy could maybe get away with this. How, you know, you're it's like a scene where a guy gets his arm cut off by mistake in the hospital, and then the doctor shows him the, on a scale of 1 to 10, which pain face are you? Are you or So, and by the way, I'm At the end of several weeks, to avoid figuring out any issues, YouTube stood by its decision to ban me. But not until after telling me several times that what I did is not actually against the TOS in any way. At least they are pretty sure. There's a few typos in there. All right. So this is crazy. So here's me emailing with them. This is Noriel again. I said, yeah, that doesn't make any sense. Can I ask, is it against TOS to upload videos that advertise content on other websites? She says, hi there. Thank you for your response. Currently, we don't have an exact article or documentation if it is against TOS to upload videos that advertise content on other websites. So that's really interesting wording. Number one, yes, they do. They do have an article that says that. It's the spam, scams, and deceptive practices thing. So she doesn't even know that exists. And number two, the way she says that, currently we don't have an exact article or documentation, that's because they need to leave that wiggle room of one day. Oh, we didn't think of that one yet. Oh, we'll add that. You know, when you get that notification where they're like, we've updated our terms of service. Yeah, because one day they're going to do that. So that's from Noriel. She doesn't know. Now, here's an interesting one. I talked to a guy named Leo. Ladies and gentlemen, brand new guy, Leo.
Give it up for Leo.
All right, now we've got Leo. Hi, my name is Leo. How are you doing today? And I just go right to the business on this one. What would constitute tricking others into leaving YouTube for another site in a video? How would content violate that part of the TOS? Now, here's something you need to know about the way the contact thing works.